I'm Brad Nessler, joined by the coach, Lee Corso, and the quarterback, Kirk Herbstreit. The players will have to battle the rain in today's contest between the Sam Houston State Bearcats and the Wofford Terriers. Well, folks, we're excited to bring you what appears to be another great gridiron matchup. And here come the Terriers. I think this thing's a toss-up. We've got two teams today that can really get it done on both sides of the ball.
Sam Houston State has a guy at wide receiver that everybody's talking about, and for good reason. He's the strength of this offense, an offense that can really spread the ball around. Lee, watch for him to come up big in this one.
This will be a good game, but the winner of today's game will be Sam Houston State.
Wofford lines up to kick this one off, and we're just about set to get underway. He kicks it. Number four fields it at the 26. Now we'll get to see how this quarterback can do today as he comes out onto the field for the first time. This offense rallies around their quarterback, and we expect to see much of the same today, fellas.
Absolutely, Brad. This kid has a great arm, is poised in a pocket, and more importantly, is a great leader of this team. I think he's going to have a tremendous game today.
Yeah, this kid's the heart and soul of this team. I also think he's going to make some good things happen today.
They'll get the ball here at the 35-yard line.
First and 10.
The Terriers come out of the power eye. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard. They line up at the 34. Second and 9. Off to the fullback. They'll bring him down at the 32. He plows ahead for a 2-yard gain. They line up at the 32. Third down. The Terriers line up in the power eye formation. Play action. Wants to throw outside.
Number 86, the intended receiver on the play.
Fourth and seven. So they're set to punt this one away. Number 31 is waiting for the snap. Number 31 punts it, and he didn't get much distance on it. Signals for a fair catch.
This is a pretty good place for them to start their first drive.
Yeah, this is a great opportunity early on in the game to get some points on the board, Coach.
First and 10, ball on their own 12. Sam Houston State comes out in the shotgun. First down, looking to throw. And now he's going to run. He's tackled at the 18-yard line.
With the carry, gain of 6 on the play.
From their own 18-yard line, it's second down. Six DBs in the lineup. Hand off to the left. Tackle made at the 20. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
Gain of 2 on the play.
Third down.
Defense! Defense! Defense!
The Bearcats are lining up with three receivers. Number seven throws. That's incomplete.
Yo, that was a tough pass for him to hold on to.
Yeah, but it wasn't the pass that was the problem. The hit is what jarred the ball loose.
Hey, the quarterback is the one who left his wide receiver out to dry. You have to throw those passes in a place where the guy can protect himself.
Sam Houston State ready to punt this one away. Number six is back awaiting the punt. It's away, short punt. Number six takes it at the 45.
You guys remember what this offense did the last time they had the ball?
Did they have the ball before?
Exactly. It was three and out so fast they had to ask for slow-mo replay to recap it.
Good field position here. They'll start this drive inside their opponent's territory. First down, looking to throw. Surveys the field. Wants to throw outside. He had to get rid of that one in a hurry.
The defensive coordinator cooked up a good blitz package that time, and although it didn't result in a sack, it forced a bad throw.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 44. The Terriers with a full house backfield. Back to pass. Throws it to the outside. And this one falls incomplete. Number six was the intended target. That'll bring up third down. From the 44-yard line, we've got third and 10. The defense lines up in a dime. He's looking to pass. He looks. He's going left. We knew this drive was in trouble if they couldn't get the pass game going, and it's safe to say that's the case, as he had zero completions. Wofford ready to punt this one away. Number 31 is back deep to return. Number 31 punts it, and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Number 19 signals for a fair catch. Not a very good series for this offense on their last drive as they were forced into a three and out.
Boy, oh boy, they had nothing going last time.
Yeah, maybe, Scooter, you need to get out there and show them what you're made out of.
Somebody get me a helmet quickly.
They'll go to work at the 25. Sam Houston State comes to the line with three wide. Gets the ball. No, they faked it. It's complete.
How about that play?
Well, it was a good pass, a good catch, and they are keeping the defense off balance by throwing on first down.
Absolutely right.
From their own 39-yard line, first down. They'll work from the shotgun. Number seven delivers, and they couldn't hook up on that one. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
And that's a throw he should make every single time.
It's second down.
Ball on the 39-yard line.
Sam Houston State comes out of the shotgun. They give to the tailback. Brought down at the 49-yard line. And that one goes for a big, big first down.
You know, every time you run the ball successfully like that, that defense starts to creep up a little bit. That's when you go to the air, my friend. Over the top.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 49. The Bearcats set up in the gun. He drops back. Comes across the middle. The quarterback saw the blitz and let it fly, but too high.
Oh, that rhymes.
So it's second and 10.
Ball on the 49-yard line.
Wofford comes out in the 3-4. And now he's going to throw it. Incomplete.
Well, the players love to run these types of plays because it's out of the ordinary of what they usually do on offense. So when they finally call the play, you have to execute it because you don't get many chances to do it again.
And I think they have the wrong guy throwing the football. But I guess that's why he's not the real quarterback.
They come out with three wide receivers. He drops back. Looks like he's going to run. Breaks one. And down he goes at the 39-yard line. They'll grab 10 yards there.
Play.
It's fourth down now, and we'll see the punt team. Number 10 is back to receive. Didn't get all of that one. Number 10 calls for the fair catch. The defense did a nice job of shutting down this offense the last time they had the ball.
The offense was not clicking at all. Let's see if they're back on the same page.
They'll set up shop at the 20-yard line.
The drive at the 20-yard line. First and 10.
Drops back to pass. He lets it go. Incomplete pass. Number 88 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it second down. It's second down. At the 22. That'll be a 2-yard gain. Third down.
Ball on the 22-yard line.
Back to pass. And they got him.
There's nothing stopping the defense from getting the sack there, Coach.
It's tough for a quarterback to throw the football when he has that kind of rush coming at him.
So they're set to punt this one away. Number 89 is the deep man awaiting the return. It's a short kick. Number 89 fields it at the 46. They're just about ready to get this drive started after their last series had some promise, but it ended with a punt. They'll take over at the 45. Sam Houston State sets up with four receivers. Here's a little draw play. Excellent open field tackle. A 1-yard gain on the play.
1-yard gain on the play.
From the 44-yard line, it's second down. Number 7 comes to the line with 3 wide. Steps up in the pocket. Can't wrap him up. He's wrapped up for the sack. And that's the end of the first quarter, and there's still no score. Third and 15 coming up. Ball right around midfield. The Bearcats are lining up with 3 receivers. Looking, he fires this one. And this one falls incomplete. Number 18 was the intended target on the play. And that'll make it fourth down. So they're set to punt this one away. Number 6 is back deep to return the punt. Hangs it up high. Fumbles the ball. Defense has it. It's one of the corners. Wow, very close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football.
Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
They'll go to work at the 26-yard line. Give to the tailback. They'll get him for a loss. They didn't let him get anything going on that play.
No, they didn't. Heck, they didn't even let him get back to the line of scrimmage.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second and 11. Taken down at the 26. That run didn't go far. They'll spot the ball a yard from the line of scrimmage. Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 26. back to back. Looks, under heavy pressure. They'll knock him down for a loss. Picks up the loose ball, and he's tackled at the 19. Good hustle there by the D lineman.
He saw the ball pop out and just went after it. Nice hustle.
It sure was. It's often an overused term when referring to defensive linemen, but that's what they mean when they talk about a guy has a motor that's running. He never quit, and he played to the whistle.
The Terriers come out in a 34 defense. He throws it. He snags it. And he's stopped behind the line. Loss of about two. Second down. Wofford brings in the nickel here. He's looking to pass. Looking. Throws. And it's going the other way. Tackle at the 38. And the defense just picked up their second interception of the half.
These guys have showed up to play today, Coach.
Yeah, they really seem to have this quarterback figured out. He hasn't been too successful today.
They'll start this drive at the 38-yard line.
First and 10.
The defense is playing the pass on this one.
Picked off.
It's the safety who's in the right place at the right time.
The quarterback has to know where the safety is when he makes this kind of throw. Right here, he just tried to force something that wasn't there.
They'll set up shop at the 41-yard line.
First and 10.
The Bearcats set up in the gun. He throws. Bounces off a would-be tackler. Brought down at the 38. About 3 yards on the play fake.
3 yard gain on the play.
It's second down and 7 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Sam Houston State comes out of the shotgun. Drops back to pass. This one is incomplete. He put just a little too much power behind that throw to his receiver.
Oh, boy, guys. I think he'd like that pass back.
Yeah, Kirk, he won't miss that receiver too often.
They line up at the 38. Third down, 7 yards to go. From the gun, looks to pass, steps up, looks, he's looking for his man, and that one's incomplete. So since the quarterback and receiver couldn't hook up, we're going to have a fourth down. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. They'll work from the shotgun. Back to pass. He steps up, surveys the field, throws it out there. Got him on the run. Tackle made at the 17. What did you see there, guys?
The defense was in zone coverage. The offense did a good job of protecting the quarterback, and he threw a nice ball to get the first down.
And the receiver ran a nice route to get open between the zone coverage.
First down, 10 yards to go. They're inside the 20. The Bearcats line up with three wide. On play action, he looks, throws, gets past the tackler. Look at the power. And they make the stop at the 6 yard line.
This is a simple case of finding the hole in the zone. The quarterback did a good job of recognizing the coverage and then found his man.
Yep, give the receiver some credit too. He got open, then made a nice catch for the first down.
They're in the red zone. The Bearcats come out in the shotgun. He drops back. He keeps it. He's tackled at the 2. Sam Houston State will take their first time out of the half. 2 minutes to go in the half. Let's see if they can take this one in for six. Play fake. Throws it. It falls incomplete. Number 40 was the intended target. That'll make it third down. This is a very important play for both teams. It's third and goal from the two. Shotgun formation. Let's see if they run the draw here. Feeds it to the back. And he's tackled at the one-yard line. And he gets a yard on the run.
1 yard gain on the play.
This isn't much more than an extra point. Sam Houston State could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and they tack on 3 points. Number 17, ready to kick. And it's a short kickoff. Number 86, fields it at the 27.
Great job by the defense last time forcing the pick. I wouldn't be surprised to see a few runs here by the offense to start things off.
They'll go to work at the 39-yard line.
Start the drive at the 39-yard line. First and 10.
He's looking to pass. Looking. He rolls left. He tosses it short. And they couldn't hook up on that one. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
They line up at the 39. It's second down and 10 to go. Lets it fly, catches it, tackled for a loss. That'll be a 2 yard loss.
Loss of two on the play.
They line up at the 37. We've got third and 12. Back to pass. He steps up. He gets rid of it, and it's picked off. And they turn it over right before the half.
Well, this really hurts them here. They're trying to cut into that lead before they got into the showers for halftime, but unfortunately, this turnover will still leave them down as they get into the locker room.
They'll take over at the 43-yard line. Number 7 lines up in the shotgun. They'll throw on first down. He'll dump this one off. It's complete. Steps out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Sam Houston State will take their second time out of the half. First and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. The Bearcats with four receivers. He drops back. Tosses short. And this one falls incomplete. Number 4 was the intended receiver on the play, so that'll make it second down. It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 30. Number 7 lines up with 5 wide out. Look at the throw. Throws in a hurry. Incomplete. Almost picked off. Not a great throw by the quarterback.
I don't know who he was throwing that one to.
I know. I think the intended receiver was the safety.
Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. The Bearcats set up in the gun. Drops back to pass. Over the middle. And it's incomplete. And that was out of reach for his tight end. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They come out with four wideouts. Here we go. And now he's going to run. Brought down in the open field. Big stop there for the defense.
And you can feel a little bit of momentum shift there, Coach.
Yep, that was a very crucial turnover on downs, because now this offense has a chance to get themselves right back into the game.
They'll start this drive at the 23.
First and 10.
Little handoff. They'll bring him down at the 28. Number 22 gains about 5 yards on the run. From their own 28-yard line. Second and 5 coming up here. They'll get him for a loss. Well, the defense really put the clamps down on that run.
Boy, Brad, great effort up front by that defense.
Well, we've played a half of football, and our score is Sam Houston State 3, Wofford nothing. Sam Houston State will be kicking off to start the second half. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. He dropped it. Number 6. Fields at the 29. Kirky broke the cardinal rule there. He ran without the football.
You know, as a return man, your first responsibility is to catch the ball and then worry about the return. He just lost his concentration there.
They'll start at the 37.
At the 37-yard line. First and 10.
He drops back. Trying to loft one long. He's got a man wide open. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
Yeah, and that's a throw he should make every single time.
Second down.
Ball on the 37-yard line.
He's tackled at the 47-yard line. That's a 10-yard gain. It's third and inches. Ball on their own 47. Hands it off. And down he goes at the 49. And that'll be good enough to move the sticks.
Great run. And now, we've got a new set of downs.
It's first and 10. They'll try to power it with a fullback. Tackle made at the 49-yard line. He got back to the line of scrimmage, but not much more. They line up at the 49. It's second and 10. They'll keep it on the ground again. Loose football. Defense says they've got it, and they do. Not a good time to fumble the football.
And that guy feels horrible about it. He's got to forget about it. Go out there and play hard the next time they hit the field.
And believe me, this kid wants another chance to redeem himself. He won't fumble again.
And they'll take over at midfield.
First and 10.
Sam Houston State comes to the line with 3 wide. Number 7 throws it out there. Number 18 was the intended receiver on that pass. That'll make it second down. from their own 48-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. The Bearcats, with four receivers, gets the ball. No, they faked it. He lets it go. He snags it. The tight end with a nice catch there.
9-yard gain on the play.
Third down and a yard. Ball on the 43-yard line. They'll work from the shotgun. Under pressure, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. Somebody came free there.
Yeah, the linebacker shot through and nobody picked him up.
He was all over him, Kirk. He wasn't letting the quarterback get anywhere.
The Bearcats are lining up to punt it away. Number 26 is back deep to return. Number 26 punts it, and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Number 26 signals for a fair catch. Their last drive ended when they decided to try for it on fourth down and were turned away by the defense. The offense will start at the 24.
At the 24-yard line. First and 10.
Gives it off. And he's tackled at the 27. Number 22 gains around 3 yards on the run. They line up at the 27. Second and 7. Straight ahead with the fullback. He's taken down at the 32. About 5 yards there on the fullback carry. From their own 32-yard line. Third down. They'll run for the first on third and short. He got hit hard. And they convert the first down on that run.
Now the key to that play is a good blocking up front by the Hog Mollies.
You're right, and those are the kind of runs that you need to have a successful offense.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. Wofford lines up in the bone, gives to the tailback. At the 40. He's all the way down to the 27-yard line. Wow, that was an outstanding run by the tailback.
Yeah, see that play? You give the kid the ball, but sometimes you don't expect him to get as many yards as he gets with it.
Yeah, but they'll gladly take it.
First down, 10 yards to go.
27-yard line.
He'll keep it on the ground again. Brought down at the 23-yard line. A 4-yard pickup by the fullback. They line up at the 23. It's second down and 6 to go. Drops back to pass. Surveys the field. Lets it fly. Almost picked off. Number 84 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it third down. The offense faces another third down as they line it up. Sam Houston State lines up in a dime defense here. Back to pass. And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
They came with the pressure that time. That was a relentless blitz by the defense.
I think there were more rushers than blockers coming at that time.
Yep, the quarterback didn't have any time to find the open man.
It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Here we go. Moves up in the pocket. Looking. Sacked. And they'll turn it over. Not much of a chance on that one.
Well, they had to go for it. You're at a point where there's not much time left, and you got to put it all on the line.
This drive will start at the 36-yard line. Number 7 is back in the gun, drops back on first down. He unloads it, finds his receiver.
You know, it's really easy to overlook those guys on the line.
Yeah, the defense came after them, and those linemen held them long enough for the quarterback to throw for a first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Sam Houston State lines up in a shotgun set. Here's a counterplay. Got some open field. He breaks it. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. What a run.
Here they give it to the tailback and a little misdirection play. And you can see the athleticism and the ability to make guys miss. Nice play.
First down.
Ball on the 32-yard line.
We're only separated by a field goal as the third quarter comes to a close. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 32. Number 7 comes to the line with 3 wide. Across the middle. That's incomplete.
Oh, man, he just overthrew him that time.
Yeah, he just missed his man. Good play call.
Bad pass.
It's second and 10.
Ball on the 32-yard line.
Fakes to the back. Number 7 with a bullet. And it falls incomplete.
Oh, you gotta hit the open man.
That's a painful incompletion for the offensive coordinator to watch.
Third down and 10 coming up. Ball on the 32-yard line. The Bearcats come out in a shotgun. Back to pass. Throw. Caught. And down he goes at the 20. Wow, how about that third down conversion?
Boy, what a play here, guys. I'm really impressed with the poise of this young quarterback. He was very cool and collected out there on that third and long play.
First and 10. We'll see what they can do in the red zone. They're in the red zone again, but this time they should be thinking touchdown. Tackle made at the 18-yard line. About 2 yards there on that delayed handoff. They line up at the 18. Second down. They'll work from the shotgun. Looking to throw. Wants to get it out on the screen. It's complete. Touchdown, Sam Houston State.
Well, at least one of these teams know how to find the end zone.
It hasn't exactly been a shootout today, but hey, how many times do we get to witness a shutout?
Not many, Kirk. Not many. But I think you might have just jinxed them by talking about it.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So with just over 4 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the score is Sam Houston State 10, Wofford nothing. Sam Houston State is lining up to kick this one off. Number 6 and number 84 back ready to return. He kicks it. Number 6 fields it at the 26. The 50. At the 40. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. They return it all the way for the touchdown.
A spectacular showcase of skills there, guys.
No question. That was one of the most amazing returns I've seen in a long time.
What was special about this, Coach, is the fact that he made some nice moves early, and then once he got to the open, you saw his ability to outrun the coverage.
And he hits the PAT. So with less than 4 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter, our score, Sam Houston State 10, Wofford 7. Number 25 looks ready to kick this one off. And this one's a short kick. Number 89 takes it to 25. Not a lot of trouble scoring the last time they had the ball. Let's see if that passing game does the trick again. They'll set up shot at the 41. First and 10. Three-man front defensively. Number 7 lets it fly. And they couldn't hook up on that one. He overthrew the receiver.
The intended receiver on the play.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 41-yard line. Wofford lines up defensively in a 3-4. He drops back. Steps up in the pocket. He's in trouble, and he can't get away from the pressure. Third and about 15 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 36. Number 7 lines up in the shotgun. He's looking to pass. He looks. He throws it. And that one's incomplete. The quarterback aired it out, but too far.
Yeah, great try by the receiver. Technically, he caught the pass, but he won't get credit for the catch because he was out of bounds.
Sam Houston State ready to punt this one away. Number 6, the return man. Number 26 punts it, and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Number 6 fields it at the 42. Well, guys, as this offense takes the field, tell me what you think they need to do to get back in the game.
Right now, it's a 3-point game, and I expect this offense to be very aggressive in trying to get the ball down the field.
And I'd expect the defense to be equally as aggressive in going after this quarterback to force some bad throws and possibly a turnover.
You're right, Coach. They just need to put together a solid drive.
Hands it off. Brought down at the 44-yard line. Number 22 comes away with 2 yards on the carry. From their own 44-yard line, second and 8. On the ground, up the middle. And he's taken down at the 49. And the fullback busts through for about 7 yards. From the 49-yard line, third and 1. They'll try to get the first on the ground. He's taken down at the 45. And it looks like he got the first down.
I'll tell you what, Brad, that is very close. I didn't think he was going to make it there, Coach.
Kirk, I agree with you 100%. I thought he was stopped short, too. This kid shows some real determination on that run.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Got hit as he threw. And that one's fallen incomplete. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45. On the ground, left side.
There he goes.
To the 20, to the 10. He's all the way down to the 1 yard line. That was a huge lift.
Brad, you're right. A run like that can really get the momentum rolling.
They're threatening inside the 20. They're crowding the line. It's the tailback.
Touchdown, and now they're in front.
It's now a 3-point game, Kirk, and I'm assuming he has the extra point here. That lead becomes 4.
Which means a field goal won't cut it. They have to get the ball into the end zone, and this possession is probably going to be their last chance.
Here's the kicking team to try the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. So with less than 2 to go in the fourth quarter, the score is Wofford 14, Sam Houston State 10. To kick.
Is lined up for the kickoff. Number 89, back deep to return.
And it's a short kickoff. He dropped it. Number 4 fields it at the 26. Guys, what do you think about this situation?
This is obviously a big possession. They have to get the ball in the end zone right here.
And this is their last opportunity, Kirk. If they don't score here, then they can call it a night.
First and 10. Going with the shotgun here. He looks to throw on first down. Throws it to the outside. The 50, at the 40, at the 30, to the 20, to the 10.
Touchdown! And now they're winning this ball game.
And they are just an extra point away from making this a 3-point game.
I think it's safe to say that this next possession will be huge. I mean, really huge.
But you can't ask for much more in an action-packed game like this, right, Coach?
I love it!
Now the extra point to take a field goal lead. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So with less than 2 to go in the fourth quarter, the score is Sam Houston State 17, Wofford 14. Number 6 is back ready to receive, and boy, has he been the game breaker on special teams today. And this one's away. Number 84 fields it at the 24. There's a fumble. It's scooped up. And a costly fumble.
The ball carrier had only one hand on the ball, and the helmet right there causes the fumble.
Congratulations to our players of the game. Both of these young men should hold their heads up high today. Number 7 comes to the line with 3 wide. And he's stopped behind the line. Wofford will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. They line up at the 46. Second and 12 coming up here. The Bearcats line up in a goal line formation. The halfback with a carry. He's tackled in the open field. Wofford will take their second time out of the half. They line up at the 42. Third down, 8 yards to go. This defense is in the dime. Look out! It falls incomplete. Excellent series by this defense, forcing them to go three and out.
And the offense really struggled on this drive. They're going to have to pick it up if they want to move the ball on these guys.
They line up to punt this one away. Number 26 is back awaiting the punt. Number 26 punts it, and it doesn't look like he got all of that one. Number 26 fields it at the 17. What do you guys think this offense has to do to get their team back in this game?
I think they need to play it very aggressive here. Forget about the field goal in overtime. They need to win this game right now.
I agree, Coach. This game is in the offense's hands. I think they have enough time to move the ball down the field and put it in the end zone. I certainly wouldn't want this game heading to overtime if I were on offense right now.
Across the middle. Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
You got to be careful throwing in the coverage like that.
Well, Coach, I don't think it was a poor decision. It was just a great reaction by the man in coverage.
So that'll make it second down. Second and 10, ball on the 18-yard line. Drops back to pass. He's sacked at the 17-yard line. They line up at the 17. It's third and 11. Sam Houston State brings in the nickel here. Back to pass. Throwing left. The ball is tipped. This one will fall incomplete.
He wasn't letting the receiver get to that one.
That's a big play on third down to get a hand in there and break up the pass.
I think the quarterback would like to have that one back.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They need this pass. Steps up, surveys the field. Incomplete pass. They hold on fourth down.
Now that's how you get a team motivated. I wouldn't be surprised to see their offense take the field with an explosive power attack.
They're inside the 20.
At the 17-yard line. First and 10.
Sam Houston State is about ready to celebrate a big victory here. Wofford will take their final timeout. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 19-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. From the 21-yard line, third down and 14 to go. Sam Houston State comes to the line with three wide. They hand it off. He's tackled at the 19-yard line. They tried to run the ball for the first down, and they didn't get it.
No, sir. You saw the defense just power through their blocks and wham into them.
There's the final gun, and this game is history. Kirk, what'd you think of this one?
I'm sad to see this one end because it was a great game to watch. Wofford played a good game out there, but they needed to make one or two more big plays, and they couldn't do it. Who knows? Another couple of minutes, and this one may have gone the other way.
Folks, it's been a lot of fun, and I hope you can join us again next time. Our final score on this one, Sam Houston State, 17, Wofford, 14.